Hi, boys and girls. Today we want to continue talking about adding tens to any number. So we have talked that when we look at a number, we know that each digit is in a certain place. So we talked about how if we have it, we have the first number is going to be the tens, and the second number is going to be the ones. Now, yesterday, we talked about how we're going to look at the tens and see how many tens there are, and then add the tens together first and then add the ones onto it. Now, today, I want to talk about breaking it apart and then adding the tens. So if I look, we have been talking about number bonds for quite a bit of time. If I look at this 20, that I know that there is a 2 and a 4. If I break it apart, I know that this has 2 in the 1 and the tens place. There's a 2 in the tens place. If I have 2 tens, how much do I have? I'm hoping you're saying 20. So if I have 2 tens, I have 20. And if then I have 4 ones, I have 4. So I have 2 tens, and which is 20, and then 4 ones, which is 4. So now I want to add together my 20 plus 40. Well, I know 2 plus 4 is 6, and then I'm just going to put my 0 at the end. Then I don't have any ones over here, so all I have to do is add my 4. So if I have 60 plus 4 more, I can say 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, or I know that this 4 is just going to go in that zeros spot. So my answer is 64. So we break apart the number that doesn't have a zero in the ones place and add it to the other 10. All right, so let's do another one. So looking at these two numbers, which one am I going to break apart? Hopefully you said 17. So when I look at 17, I'm looking at my two digits. If I have, I'm going to break this number apart. And if I have, I have a 1 in the tens place. So if I have 1 10, how much do I have? 10, right? And then I have 7 ones. How much do I have? 7. So now I'm going to add together my two numbers that have a zero at the end. If I look, I have a 5 and a 1. Well, 5 plus 1 is 6. Then I'm going to put a 0 at the end. Now I'm going to add my 1 onto it. So how much do I have? 60 plus 7 more. Remember, I'm just going to take that 7 and put it on that 0. And so I know I have 67. So 50 plus 17 is 67. And I didn't put this one up here, so I'm going to go ahead up to the top. All right, so let's look at the next one. Which one am I going to break apart? This one has a 0. This one doesn't. So this is the one I'm going to break apart. So I have a 3 in the tens place. If I have 3 tens, how much is that? 30 plus 5 ones. How much is that? 5. So now I'm going to add these two together that have a 0 at the end. So I have a 3 and a 5, which is going to be 8. And then put my 0 at the end. Plus, now I'm adding the ones. So 80 plus 5 more if I need to. 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85. Or put that 5 right on top of there. And so now I know that this is equal to 85. So 35 plus 50 is 85. 85. So now I've got the last one. Which one am I breaking apart? 24. So if I have the 2 and the 4, the 2 is in tens place. So if I have 2 tens, I have 20 plus 4 ones, which is what? 4. So now I'm going to add these two together because they both have a 0. 7 plus 2 is what? 9. And then I'm going to add the 0 at the end. Now I'm going to add my ones. So what is my answer? 90 plus 4 more. I can do 90, 91, 92, 93, 94. Or I take that 4 and put it right in that 0 spot. So I have 94. So 70 plus 24 is 94. I want to do one of these showing like I did yesterday. Remember, when I add numbers like this, they have to stay in their column. They have to stay in their column. So if I have 70, a 7 and a 0, my plus sign is out here, plus 24. When I write it like this, I start with the ones first. 0 plus 4 is 4. Set. Now I'm done with the ones place. Now I'm going to add the tens. 7 plus 2 tens is 9 tens. So my answer, I'm going to circle it since it's so close to that, is 94. Okay, so there's more than one way to solve these problems that have two-digit numbers. We're adding two digits to two digits when we're doing these numbers. All right, so we'll continue working on this the rest of this week and next week. Hopefully, you're figuring out how to submit your workbook page. If you're having issues, you can just take a picture of it and send it to me. And so we'll continue to work on this. It's exciting because this shows that you're getting bigger and ready for second grade. Everyone have a great day.